If you've been watching the World Series, you've been watching a number of baseball players who made the jump to the big leagues after competing in the Arizona Fall League, which is designed to help develop the sport's top prospects. Now in its 20th season, the Fall League has earned quite a reputation for turning out talent. Look no further than the 2011 All-Star Game played here in Phoenix. 41 players on All-Star rosters were Fall League alums. Here to tell us more about the Fall League is Steve Cobb. He's Major League Baseball's director of the Arizona Fall League. Good to see you again. Thanks for joining
us. It's always great to visit with you.
20th? Are you surprised this lasted for 20 years?
There's really been an evolution with the league. And to look back I've actually been here 19 of those 20. And to look back and see how the respective major league organizations have embraced this league and now actually utilize it, it's very rewarding. And just the sheer numbers of players that have played in this league and gone on to the major leagues, that number's pushing 2,000 players.
My goodness. But was it tough for the league, for the baseball clubs, the big league clubs, to embrace this at first? Because I know it was just getting this whole thing started was a bit of a project.
Well, at the very beginning, when we started the concept, it involved putting five organizations together and just sharing information, different approaches in terms of player development was a real concern. But over the years, the organizations have learned that, this process does work. It's beneficial for the players. It's beneficial for the staff.
And this was basically a domestic option for places like Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, Venezuela, these kinds of winter ball places.
Exactly. That's why it was created, so that primarily U.S.-born players could stay here in the States and hone their skills. Before this league, they had to go to the other countries, and the cultural differences in certain cases presented challenges for them.
Let's talk about some of these players. These aren't just good players or they could be good players. This is the cream of the crop in terms of prospects, correct?
Absolutely. These are the players that are literally on the cusp of making it to the major leagues. Many of them most fans have not heard of yet, but 1 year from now, after 19 years of operation, I can simply say that between 75 and 100 players that are in the league this year will make it to the major leagues, and the numbers go up even greater after a two-year span.
So who decides which players play in the league and which players play on which teams?
Well, the players are invited by their parent organization. So if you put that in perspective, each organization must send 7 players, and there's 125 to 150 players in a minor league system. So if you're selected one of the 7, you're feeling pretty good about yourself, and frankly, you're probably pretty talented. So that whole process is done by the organizations, and then we put the 5 organizations together to form the rosters.
Okay, let's talk about the games themselves. Where do the teams play, and when do they play?
Well, we're actually about halfway through our season right now. We began on October 4th, and we'll continue through November 19th. We play at 6 spring training sites. We play at Surprise Stadium, Peoria Stadium, Mesa Hohokam, Phoenix Municipal Stadium, Scottsdale Stadium, and the brand new Salt River Fields Stadium.
Yeah, that was the one I was wondering about. I mean, that's got to be a gem out there to be able to play there.
It's a wonderful facility. Fans have been responding to that. It's just a great place to watch a game if you haven't been out to a Fall League game.
Talk about the fans. How many fans usually go out to a game? Day game, night game, weekends, change much?
Yes, we'll draw less people during the day. We normally have 2 day games and 1 night game. The day games are at 12:35 and 6:35 for the evening. That's set up primarily for the scouting community.
Interesting.
That they can come in, see an afternoon game, and then go to the night game. And in theory, when they do that, they have covered 20 organizations in just 1 day.
Wow. Describe the crowd. Now, who shows up for these games? I know I show up for a couple of these games, but who besides me?
Well, during the day, we get a significant retiree population, certainly people that are into autograph seekers and people of that nature. And then just real avid baseball fans. It's a real nice, comfortable crowd. And at night, we tend to attract more families that yes. will come to our games.
Yeah, and the weather at night right now is fantastic.
I mean, perfect.
It's perfect baseball weather.
We're not dealing with the weather that they've been having in St. Louis for the World Series.
Yeah, and it's not like they have a 100% chance of rain for the next game. Training ground for umpires, training ground for coaches and future managers as well?
The development thread goes through the umpires, the managers. We've had 29 former fall league managers become major league managers. Managers like Mike Socia, managers like Terry Francona, Don Mattingly, some big names.
Yeah.
And same thing with the umpiring community. Over 50% of the major league umpires right now had their final training in the Arizona Fall League.
Isn't that something? You said you've been here 19 to the 20 years. Okay, that's a lot of years. That's a lot of baseball. Is there a memory that sticks out?
The one memory that I will never forget, and this is I'll make this a short story, but there was a player by the name of Butch Husky. This was in 1993, my first year. Butch was property of the Mets. He hit a home run over at Mesa Hohokam Stadium. Simple enough, but in the process, dislocated his shoulder. His swing was so hard that he dislocated his shoulder and was unable to run the bases. So another runner from his team actually went around and hit the bases and scored the home run.
As this guy was probably writhing on the ground there with his torch?
Absolutely. Never forget it as long as I live. And I didn't know what the rule was.
Can you do that?
You can in that situation because he physically could not run.
My goodness. It reminds me of who was the player that just hurt him for the Phillies? Frank Thomas. Who's it? Frank Thomas, the guy that made the last out in the Phillies series?
Oh, Ryan Howard.
Ryan Howard. I'm sorry, Thomas. Ryan Howard. He hurt his Achilles tendon. He
exactly.
wouldn't be able to run. More information. Is there a website that fans can go to?
Yes. You can go to www.mlbfallball.com.
All right. Very good. Good to have you here, and have fun this fall.
We will. Come out and see us.
All right. Sounds